boars.
Welcome back to Hearthstone, everyone. This is SC Infester, and we are going to continue this Druid arena run. Currently 4-1, so doing pretty good. And hopefully we can go aim for something high. 9 keys and up. That'd be cool. I feel like I've drafted a pretty good deck. So, let us see what our next opponent will bring on the table. Here is a little bit of game lag here. Worthy opponent.
Malfurion versus
Jaina. Alright, I'm versus a mage, so
you asked for
hopefully
it.
I can
I protect the wild.
Try to end this by turn. By turn 7 before mages really get their huge spells rolling out. And I've got this pint-sized summoner. It won't really help me much besides being able to drop a Shattered Sun Cleric at turn 2. Unless she drops something
summoning portal open.
Like her own pint-sized summoner. So, I mean, I feel like I can drop my own pint-sized summoner. And then she'd be forced to trade. Or I could just play River Acropolis and take that out and live with one health. This is kind of a strange situation here, to be honest. Because depending on what she drops next, I could be in a fairly bad spot. Because she could drop a Harvest Golem. I'm just gonna do this. And just cross my fingers that I could play my Shattered Sun Cleric, but really is gonna be a fat
we
chain.
We must cleanse the sun well.
Oh my goodness. Alright. I'm gonna try to hold right now before next turn. Uses the ability again. And then turn 4 I could drop a Divine Shield to try to regain my board state. That would have been a scarier option, in my opinion. I don't know. I mean, being able to give her pint-sized 1-1, let her clear me without dying, and then force me to use this, so I guess actually they're both equally viable options.
What to do?
I could play Crocolisk and Direwolf, but he'll just be able to clear my Direwolf with the Harvest Golem and live. It isn't the best option to do, or rather I should say I don't have many good options right now with the cards I have in my hand.
Glory to the Centauri.
Oh no, that's even worse. Alright. What can I do? I could play a taunt.
What to do? Where shall I strike?
I guess right now I'm just trying to bank on some kind of miracle late game to happen. I have a fairly big drop next turn, so... Alright, this will do good to take care of this right now. I think it's what I want to do. I'll take a lot of damage, but... Then I'll play, I think actually I'm going to play this. So I could force him... This will kind of force him to kill... I'm going to play this in Shattered Sun because this will kind of force him to hit my Direwolf first. Assuming with a spell or a Zero Grade.
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
And then his Harvest Golem will hit my, this guy, if everything goes as planned. Of course, nothing really goes as planned ever in a card game, but he's gonna whip out something like Blizzard or something to make me sad.
What to do? What to do?
But we'll just chill here and see what happens. For now, I'll just destroy all the doodads around the map. Anger the griffin.
Your magic shall not save
you. Oh, silence. That's unfortunate.
Mind if I roll need?
Oh, if I had swipe.
For the crusade!
If I had drawn swipe. Yeah, that is quite the loss. The, what is that? The guy that removes divine shields? That guy can... It's essentially the same idea as my legendary. It just removes... It removes something that gives the other player board instantaneous board advantage by playing... Too bad. Oh well. Hopefully this game goes a bit better.
Victory or death!
I must protect the wild.
Alright, this is the card I was talking about, by the way. The Black Knight destroys a minion with taunt. It's a bit better than removing divine shields. But by the same token, that other guy gains attack and damage and health. But I could keep this in my hand. I mean, this isn't too bad to keep in my hand, because if I play this on turn 6 while he has a taunt, that'll pretty much win the game. I'm gonna return this because Power of the Wild is good enough to Power of the Wild and Wrath will be good clear and give me a little bit of board advantage. It's kind of risky to keep this in my hand, just a bit though. But yeah. I've got a panther around right now, and then next turn I could do 3 damage or 1 damage to a minion. And draw a card, so. So I'm gonna choose to actually remove this. I think.
Job's done.
I have a lot of options for turn 4 or 5, so I just have to kind of hold out next turn. And hopefully destroying that will let me ramp up. Yeah, I definitely have a really strong deck.
For the wild.
I mean, I feel like he's gonna play a Cruel Taskmaster and then Wind Fury.
Tazdingo!
Or yes. Do something like that. But I do have this, so. Right now I'm just going to. I could honestly Dark Iron Dwarf that, but I'm gonna play a big guy. Playing this would make the Worgen clear. That would be a bad idea. I don't know what's a good option right now. Because I feel like if I wait for this, that'll be too long. And my Panther will just die to the Worgen or something. So I'm just gonna...
Done.
It gives me a bigger guy than his Worgen, so I should be fine for now. And the next turn I could drop an A-bomb if I'm really in a sticky situation.
For the War Tree!
Oh, bye-bye, dwarf. Aw, that does 2 damage. It's not enough. I think I'm content with dropping a Yeti. We'll see how he responds. If he responds at all. He might just hit me in the face and summon some minions. Idealistically, he would play a pretty big taunt. I don't know if there are any 6 drop taunts.
What now?
I think he's just gonna try to clear
the line. Join or die! Or both.
Aww. And then he's just gonna hit me with that. Yeah. Pretty good. But I have this. He's just gonna hit me. And play something. Hopefully, I mean, I have a taunt so I can kind of regain.
Forward.
X marks the spot.
Oh. That's it. That was pretty good. I'm definitely gonna swipe this. And then try to kill that. I don't know if I can. I can't really kill that. I'll just play this. And then next turn, I've got an Iron Bark. I've got a couple options next turn. Ugh, but execute is very annoying.
Try this.
I am not a morning person.
Yeah, that's an immense unit. That's a ton of damage. This will be good clear.
What we do
for the wilds?
I could hit this guy and make him die as well. But that means that leads to me taking more unnecessary damage, and the fact that he could play a silence. But if he skips this turn, just for whatever reason... He has 9 mana to play some stuff. Oh, peace out.
It's time for a little blood.
Peace out. Watch this.
None shall pass.
Sorry, man. Hopefully he doesn't just whoop my ass this turn. Oh. I think I can survive and win. That's 2 damage. Alright, I have to do 11 damage. 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, but he used armor. That was 11, I think. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, that was totally 11 damage. That's 1 more. I can't end it this turn. So I'm gonna have to play some other stuff. I think this is gonna be the best. And then start cleaning his stuff. And I guess I could play River Crocolis too, but or I can... No, shielding at this point won't really do much for me, because he has stuff that can definitely kill me, regardless of a shield or not. And I'm gonna start trying to clear
I'm
his stuff.
Invincible!
Die. Largely, actually, I don't really think he can draw anything that can kill me this turn.
Well played.
Unless he drops a leper gnome or something. In which case I could shield myself for next turn and kill it. Is he gonna execute it? Oh, another Arcanite Reaper. Wow. Alright. But you can see the power of that, destroy a minion as soon as you get out. If you could pull off something like that, or a mind control tech, or something similar, like, Sylvanas Windrunner, I think, is one of the legendaries that takes control of a mob when she dies. Instantaneous. As soon as they're placed on the board, they're just full of value, so... You can guarantee some sense of value from it.
Malfurion versus Jaina.
You asked for it.
I must protect the wild.
Yes, I'm going second. I love going second. I'm going to return these. Oh, I got the Black Knight again. A lot of, I don't know, I guess it's just me, but a lot of mages draft Shield Masters. But I guess Shield Masters is the popular card because it's pretty good. So I've got a couple options here. I could coin on turn 3 to drop a Razor Fen, which will pretty much most of the time guarantee that the mage will use
what
her Fireball passive on my boar, so that kind of guarantees a removal of 2 mana on their next turn. Of course, that's just an assumption. Or I could play Power of the Wild and drop a Panther right now. And I think that's what I'm going to do, just because she didn't summon anything, and I can just clear whatever she spawns right now and then drop a Razor Fen on the third turn. Or I could drop a Scarlet Crusader. Options. Yeah, that just means, I guess, that she doesn't really have anything she can play this turn.
For the wild.
And then, I mean, that kind of implies that next turn she's gonna do that too. Which is kind of good for me, because that means she's just not doing anything for 2 turns. Which could be a little scary, because she could have a huge part of her. I mean, I have to try to get this over with quickly. Is it worth to play this right now? I guess.
Don't mess with us!
Idealistically, she fireballs the boar, and unless she top decks something that's worth two cost, then she'll play it. Or she'll drop some four cost, which I could probably deal with swipe. So I guess she's playing some kind of removal deck. I could play a Divine Shield, but I think I'm gonna take this chance to draw instead.
Pass me that arc light spanner!
Job's done.
I drew a pretty good card, so hopefully we see a taunt or something and I can play my Black Knight.
Let the pain speak to me!
Ooh, those are pretty good guards. I don't know why she didn't play those earlier. I'm gonna...
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
Kill him with that. And then wrath that.
Give me a minute!
Just to keep board advantage. I wanna stay.
Give that minion judgment to get them ready to attack.
Stay ahead because, you know, turn 7's coming up next, and I'm going to probably lose a lot of my minions because I'm always scared of mages on turn 7 when they have Fire Blast or Pyro Blast. Flame Strike. So many flame spells. What is this called? Fireball? Fire Blast. Just kidding.
What to do?
So many.
What to do?
So many different spells. So we'll see what she plays, because she's pretty unpredictable. She just decided to Fire Blast for a couple turns even though she had two drops. That was three cost. I have to be careful if that's Mirror Entity, because I don't want to play something that big. So I'm going to drop this first. Okay, so it clearly isn't Mirror Entity. So I should be fine playing this guy.
Silvermoor shall not fall.
Push forward.
Oh, it might be that one that prevents lethal, which could be bad for me. But even if she uses Flame Strike right now, I have a guy that'll survive, so. Oh, what is gonna happen? Blizzard? Something? I don't know what this guy's doing. I mean, she's just been sitting with a lot of cards in her hand forever, and she can't play anything. Or maybe she's just... I don't know. This is kind of scaring me, to be honest.
For the crusade! Remember, kill Kalash!
Maybe she's just really bad and I'm overreacting. I don't know. I actually don't know. This is terrifying. I guess I just assume that people are good. What is that?
Someday I'll be just like
you! Oh, are those gonna all be spells? Just kidding. Why didn't he play the Worgen earlier? That was just a really strange game, guys. I don't even know what was happening at the time. I'm on 6 keys. Let's try to drag this out to 9. I don't know if it'll happen, but, you know, we'll definitely try. And then we'll open the packs together to show you guys what I got. Really slow guy. There are too many of those mods, so I don't need to joke about it.
The light shall bring victory.
I must protect the
wild. I'm going
the
first
wild.
Again. I kind of want to keep this because it's just a really good card, but I'll return it. We'll take the chances. Wow, I'm drawing the Black Knight a lot in my early turns. I mean, I have a 2-drop for next turn, but it's not ideal. Hopefully he just skips his turn. This isn't something you want to play on turn 2, because... the point of it is to give adjacent minions attack. I mean, I could kill a 3-2 with it. Shadow Word Pain. I'm pretty satisfied with that trade, actually. Because I can do this and not be scared of a Shadow Word Pain on a 2-3 rather than a 2-2. Or a 2-4 in the case of a Gnomish Inventor. Not Gnomish Inventor, I mean Gnomish 4? I can't remember. The 4 for a 2-4 that draws a card. But that Yeti... Dat Yeti do. I could do Bloodfen and Shapeshift, or I could do Scarlet Crusader. What do I want to do? They both do 3 damage. That one just has Divine Shield. I'm gonna play this. Shapeshift? No. Yeah, no, yeah, no, yeah, no, yeah, no. Should I? I don't even know.
Yeah. The crusade!
Time waits for no one.
Let's see. I can hit him with this.
Suck steel, swine!
Or hit him directly for 3. I feel like that was the best option. I don't know. He could heal it. Oh, what am I doing? Is he gonna play an archer and deal 1 damage to me? Yeah, I thought so.
Well played.
I could power the wild and kill it. Or Stormpike.
I've got a huge guy!
Fact of the matter is I wanna get rid of that. I've got stuff for turn 6. Silverhand Knight, Power of the Wild, Bloodpen Raptor, and my own passive. Black Knight. Lots of options. Lots of really good options. Let's see what he plays right now though, guys. I don't know. Sack of Kitties.
Don't mess with Tusk!
Razor Fan and mana. Okay. If you played 1 more, I could have just trolled him.
I'm ready.
Let's see. 3-2, 3-2, and then 1 health, 1 armor. I can kill that. Kill that. Or I could have a 4-4 and then a 2-2.
What to do?
I think this is the best, in my opinion. Maybe I don't even need to play Power of the Wild, though, because if I kill this... This is... I definitely want to do that. But then you can just kill me with that, so it'd probably be smart to just...
Time waits for no one.
I'm just gonna do this.
For the wild!
I can give him +1/+1. But I think the character is better right now.
Job done.
I don't know, that was kind of a ballsy choice. We'll see what happens. Kind of crossing my fingers right now. Is this a beast? Yeah, it is a beast, actually.
I wonder.
I love this guy's splash art. It's just awesome. A mind control tech. I wonder if he dyed his hair pink. Because it's pretty outrageous color. For a gnome? I think it's a gnome.
We must consider
the black. I wonder what the idea was behind this guy giving him a destroy an enemy minion with taunt. It's a good ability, but a lot of the characters in you can tell have like lore-based abilities, like the Shield Master would have taunt. Or a Razor Fen Raptor, I guess, is like one of a creature that you just kill for EXP and you grind on this, so. It's just a weak character with no ability, but good early game.
What?
That's quite huge, but I'm gonna have to say sorry. This card is just great. He spent a lot of resources in playing that. Especially the double minion health, so he can't light spawn OTK me. Which is silly. Basically, you play a light spawn, you hope your opponent doesn't attack it, and then you use double minion health. And you could do that twice, even. Get it up to like 20 attack, and then destroy him. Ow. Nova. He just healed himself quite a bit. Oh, this is... Kinda wish.
Squire, attend me.
Ready, sir.
Timing finish
for the wild.
I mean, I don't know. I feel like this game is still. He could still come back from this. It'd just be kind of hard. I'm at a pretty good spot right now because I have guys that he can't just power
over. Do you call that a weapon?
Do you call that a weapon? So I have some options here. But I think I'm gonna play this game. And I could very easily have him deal with these, but we don't know if he has a power word. But I don't know if he's in any spot to just start hitting me. So I'm gonna just hit him in the face.
You
insist. I'm invincible.
You know what? I'll trade this just as the buff from the Dark Armor. But I'll leave the other guy.
Invincible.
That was a really, I'm not gonna lie, this Iron Bark was a really good top deck.
Good
quite an amazing top deck.
Must consider.
Let us see what a sack of kitties can pull out of the bag.
I got the best deals anywhere. Join or die.
That is a lot of fourth damage monsters. He's just trying to search right now. I could make him very sad, actually.
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
I don't think he can recover at this point. I don't know anything he could be doing.
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
Is someone injured?
Maybe a turn too late. He just needs to draw or something.
You have that.
That was pretty good. Let us see if we can continue. Holger, brand new player.
Malfurion.
Oh, I wish I could play against a brand new arena director.
I must protect the wild.
Okay. I mean, I could keep this also. It doesn't have bad stats for a 3 cost, but it could also save me if he just drops two summon an extra minion kind of guys. So, I'm gonna coin right now and drop something. And I think that something is going to be the Panther. Because he does more damage next turn. I can hit him next turn is what I'm trying to imply. Oh, that could also happen. And I could lose my Panther.
My thanks to you.
I will crush you!
See, I was going to say, I could play River Chronicles to protect myself from dying, but I completely forgot about... I didn't think Warriors had anything that could clear that.
It's time for a little blood.
But I mean, he had the Bomber, which proved to be some extremely good RNG for him. Let's do this. Oh, that is going to be enraged, but that's not a big problem because I could deal with it. Let's kill this.
Try this!
That's just going to kill it and leave it enraged. That's great. And he's got the weapon, too, from the weaponsmith. Which is such a good card. I don't really have many options. This is gonna be so bad.
For the wilds.
I don't like the way this game is going. That Mad Bomber just ruined my life. That Mad Bomber was so good.
Xbox the
Sport.
Charge forward.
Oh no, alright, this guy has just drafted quite a bit. To say the least.
I will crush you!
A natural mistake.
I could mind control tag.
Engaging TC-130, mental dislocator!
For the wild!
I don't know what I could possibly do. I mean, I could drop an abomination and then... I don't know. This is quite scary, guys. I think this game is quite over unless I could somehow drop the iron bark and stall a little bit. Hope for some good draws. Oh! Oh, it's gonna be so big and it has a charge, I think. Oh, well played.
Well played.
That was such a good play! This deck is so good. But I did lose to it. And that did quit. I guess if I had a gun, it'd be disappointing. That was just good. Enough to give me another run though. Let's open my pack and then we'll call it quits. I have a rare. Just one rare.
Golden rare!
Oh, a golden rare Argent Commander. This is such a good card, and it's golden and rare. I like this card. I like it. Let us disenchant extra cards. Alright guys, that's it for today. Thanks for tuning in. I tried my best in the arena run and did pretty good, but the decks that did beat me had pretty insane combos, such as that last one. So, once again, thanks for watching. I see Investor checking out. See you guys later.